Hello everyone, this is Ankur Chaudhary, and in this video lecture I'll be covering current affairs from India and across the world from 1st April 2018 till 15th April 2018. So these are the broad areas that I'll be covering throughout the course of this presentation. First, let's take up news from awards and honors. Firstly, Bollywood actor turned politician Mr. Vinod Khanna was conferred the Dada Saheb Phalke Award posthumously. Now, the Dada Saheb Phalke Award is the highest honor in the field of cinema in the country. It is given by the Directorate of Film Festivals, which comes under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. So, as we know, Mr. Vinod Khanna, he passed away last year. He was the sitting MP from the constituency of Gurdaspur in the state of Punjab. Next, Bollywood actress Anushka Sharma will be honored with the 2018 Dada Saheb Phalke Excellence Award for her successful movies as a producer. Next, Ranveer Singh will get the 2018 Dada Saheb Phalke Excellence Award for Best Actor for his movie Padmavat. Next, the State of the Year Award was given to the state Chhattisgarh under the Business Leader category as part of the India Business Leadership for the remarkable increase in business and services activities in various sectors. This award was given by a leading business magazine of the country to Chhattisgarh. Next, the prestigious Indian Institute of Science, which is located in Bengaluru, was adjudged the overall best Indian university in the National Institutional Ranking Framework 2018, which was released by the Union Minister of Human Resource Development. Now, the NIRF, that is the National Institutional Ranking Framework, had 9 categories. They were, first of all, the overall best university, which was won by Indian Institute of Science, then best universities, medical colleges, a general college offering degrees in bachelor's of arts, bachelor of commerce, etc., engineering, management, law, pharmacy and architecture. Next, the 65th National Film Awards for 2017 were announced recently, and the following were the prominent winners. The Best Film Award went to the Assamese film called Village Rockstar. Next, the Best Hindi Film went to the critically acclaimed movie Newton. Next, the Best Actor Female Award was given to Sridevi posthumously, that is after her death, for her role in the movie called Mom. And next, the Best Actor Male Award went to the Bengali actor called Riddhi Sen for his movie Nagar Kirtan. So the National Film Awards were instituted in the year 1954 and are presented every year by the Directorate of Film Festivals, which comes under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India. The National Film Awards are presented by the President of India. Next, we look at some important news from the world of business. Firstly, India is now the second largest mobile phone producer in the world after China, after India overtook Vietnam. So, in 2017, India produced around 11 million mobile phones in the country. So, next, we see some important news from politics. Firstly, the FSSAI, that is the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. I repeat, Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. You must have seen its labels on various edible products like chocolates, biscuits and whatever that you consume. So this is a Safety and Standards Authority of India. It launched a unique initiative called Project Dhoop. Dhoop as in sunlight, to encourage schools to shift their morning assembly to around noon time to ensure maximum absorption of vitamin D in students through natural sunlight. Next, the Maharashtra government and the Tata Trust have come together to finance the state's first poultry company to be run and owned by tribal women. So the Maharashtra government would be contributing funds of up to 12 crores and Tata Trust's about 3 crores in this project. Next, the Piyush Goyal, the Union Minister for Railways and Coal, launched the Uttam app for coal quality monitoring in the country. Now, Uttam is an acronym for unlocking transparency by third-party assessment of mined coal. Next, the HRD Ministry, that is the Human Resource Development Ministry, set up a high-powered committee headed by former HRD Secretary V.S. Oberoi to examine the process by which a CBSE conducts examinations. This high-powered committee has been formed due to the recent problems in CBSE in terms of evaluation of copies. That is, when a large number of mistakes have been found in the totaling of marks of students in CBSE papers. Next, we see some news from economy and finance. First, the Reserve Bank of India, that is the RBI, tightened reporting norms for the liberalized remittance scheme. Right? Remittance is basically sending of money from one country to another within a family. That is, it is not for business. So, for example, if an Indian or an NRI sends money to his family, that transaction is known as remittance. So, the RBI tightened reporting norms for the liberalized remittance scheme, under which an individual can transfer up to $2,50,000 abroad in 1 year. Right? So, it was felt that a huge amount of foreign exchange is being transferred out of the country. So, RBI has decided that a daily monitoring mechanism will be established on all such transactions which fall under this particular scheme. Next, India with an economic freedom score of 54.5 points was ranked 130th in the latest annual index of economic freedom released by a top American think tank, the Heritage Foundation. Now, this particular ranking, first country was Hong Kong, next was Singapore, next, third was New Zealand, followed by Switzerland, and then Austria. Right? Now, in these questions, it is India's ranks are important, the top three countries are important, and of course, which is the organization that releases such index? So, in this case, it would be the Heritage Foundation of the United States. Next, in its latest Asian Development Outlook 2018, the ADB, that is the Asian Development Bank, stated that India's economic growth is set to rise to 7.3% in 2018-19 and grow at 7.6% further in the next fiscal year, that is 2019-20. Next, India emerged as the third most vulnerable country in terms of risks of cyber threats such as malware, spam and ransomware in 2017 in a report by company called CMAT. The most vulnerable country is USA, followed by China, and third, of course, India. Next, India was ranked 37th out of 125 countries in the global startup ecosystem in 2017, according to the latest report released by Global Startup Ecosystem Map, known as Startup Blink. First two countries are USA and UK in this case. Next, we look at some important people making the news. Firstly, Mr. Balram Bhargav was appointed the new Director General of the Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, and the Secretary of the Department of Health Research. ICMR is the premier institute in the country involved in the area of biomedical research. Next, the book India's Heritage of Gharana Music, Pandits of Gwalior, authored by classical vocalist Meeta Pandit, was recently launched. Next, senior artist Ram Kumar passed away at the age of 94 years. He was a modernist painter and was associated with the Progressive Artists Group. Now, the Progressive Artists Group was a group of seven artists which was formed in the year 1947. Basically, what they did was they combined the ideas from historical art of India with the Western ideals and tried to formulate a different type of a stream in arts. Next, Mr. Rishad Premji, the Chief Strategy Officer and Board Member of Wipro Limited, was appointed as the new Chairman of the NASCOM for 2018 2019. So NASSCOM is the National Association of Software and Services Companies. So mostly IT companies, they have come together to form this association called NASSCOM. Next, Rosemary DiCarlo, a US diplomat, was appointed as the head of UN Political Affairs, one of the most high profile positions at the United Nations, thus becoming the first woman, this is important, to head this particular position. Next, Vishnu Sadashiv Kokje, the former Himachal Pradesh governor and Madhya Pradesh High Court judge, was elected as the new international president of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad. Next, news from sports. Firstly, Indian shooter Anish Bhanwala from Haryana, aged 15, created history by becoming the country's youngest ever gold medal winner in the Commonwealth Games. In wrestling, Bajrang Punia clinched gold in men's freestyle 65 kg wrestling category at the Gold Coast Commonwealth Games 2018. Next, Deepak Ladar, aged 18 years from Haryana, became the youngest Indian weightlifter to claim a Commonwealth Games by clinching a bronze in the men's 69 kg weightlifting category. Next, Ms. Hina Sidhu from India clinched gold in women's 25 meter pistol event at the Commonwealth Games. Now, it's not important for you to remember the names of all the events that they have won the medals in, but it is important that you know that, let us say, Ms. Hina Sidhu is involved in the sports of shooting. You need not remember 25 meter, the particular event in which she won the gold. Of course, when any Indian breaks the records at international events, that naturally becomes important. For example, Anish Bhanwala and Deepak Ladar. Next, India's mixed badminton team created history by clinching its first ever gold by defeating defending champions Malaysia in the final event at the Commonwealth Games. Next, the Kerala football team won the 72nd edition of the Santosh Trophy football tournament 2018 by defeating West Bengal in the finals. Next, veteran boxer MC Marie Kom, who claimed a gold on debut at the Commonwealth Games, was India's flag bearer at the closing ceremony of the 21st Commonwealth Games. Next, Ms. Manika Batra became the first ever Indian woman player to win the table tennis women's single gold at the Commonwealth Games, which were held in Australia. Next, Ms. MC Marie Kom became the first Indian woman boxer, right? First Indian woman boxer to claim a Commonwealth Games gold when she defeated Northern Ireland's Christina O'Hara. Next, Neeraj Chopra became the first Indian javelin thrower to claim a gold medal at the CWG 2018. Next, P. Gururaj from Karnataka bagged India's first medal at the CWG 2018 when he won silver medal in the men's 56 kg final. Next, weightlifter Saikhom Mirabai Chanu from Manipur clinched first gold for India. First gold for India means first gold in the Commonwealth Games at the 21st CWG in the women's 48 kg weightlifting category. Next, weightlifter Sanjita Chanu from Manipur clinched gold at the CWG 2018 in the women's 53 kg weightlifting category. Next, Indian shooter Shreyasi Singh won a gold. Next, weightlifter Venkat Rahul Ragala clinched gold medal in the 85 kg category at the Commonwealth Games 2018. Next, we see some important miscellaneous news. Firstly, the World Homeopathy Day was observed on April 10th to commemorate the birth anniversary of homeopathy founder Dr. Christian Friedrich Samuel Hahnemann, who was a German physician. Next, the first international conference on water, environment and climate change, knowledge sharing and partnership was held in Kathmandu, Nepal. Next, the World Health Day was observed on 7th April, like every year, with the theme Universal Health Coverage, Everyone, Everywhere. Next, ISRO, that is the Indian Space Research Organization, successfully launched the navigation satellite called IRNSS-1. This is one I into the orbit with the help of PSLV C-41 launch vehicle from the Satish Dhawan Space Center at Sriharikota in Andhra Pradesh. Now, IRNSS is an acronym for Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System. Now, it is a kind of a GPS system, but which is homemade. GPS system is, of course, consisting of 24 satellites orbiting across the Earth, and that system has been installed by USA. This GPS is basically whatever location-based services like Google Maps or whatever that you're using. So India, using its satellite system, IRNSS, a total of 8 satellites were planned. However, this was the 9th satellite which was launched because the first satellite, 1A, it failed, right? So this was launched, but it failed to respond. So the 9th satellite has been sent to replace INS-1A. PSLV is the rocket on which it was launched. So PSLV is Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle. Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle. C-41 is the code name for this particular vehicle. Next, Gujarat Chief Minister Vijay Rupani approved setting up of 5,000 megawatt capacity solar park as the Dholera Special Investment Region, which would be the largest such entity in the world after its completion. Right, so this special investment region that is being formed in Dholera in Gujarat, that would be the largest of its kind. Next, the National Safe Motherhood Day was celebrated on April the 11th with the theme Respectful Maternity Care. Next, Prime Minister Narendra Modi flagged off Indian Railways' first high-speed electric locomotive developed at the Electric Locomotive Factory, which is a collaboration between India and France in Madhepura. Next, the Indian Air Force carried out its largest ever all-encompassing combat-ready exercise, Gagan Shakti 2018. Next, the National Maritime Day was celebrated on 5th of April with the theme Indian Shipping, an Ocean of Opportunities. Next, India's longest elevated road was inaugurated by Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Mr. Yogi Adityanath. The 10.3 kilometer long Hindon Elevated Road's primary objective is to ease traffic movement from Ghaziabad to New Delhi and vice versa. Next, with an aim to combat the rising levels of air pollution in Delhi NCR region, petrol pumps in the capital started supplying ultra-clean Bharat Stage 6 grade fuel, both petrol and diesel, making New Delhi the first city in the country, right? This is important, first city in the country to switch from BS4, that is Bharat Stage 4 grade, to BS6, that is Bharat Stage 6. Now, BS or the Bharat Stage fuel standards are standards which define the maximum amount of pollutants like nitrous oxides, right, particulate matter and carbon monoxide, right? So maximum amount of emissions from these fuels, they are defined in various stages. Now, BS6 standards will be implemented in the country shortly, and New Delhi has become the first city in the country to have implemented them. So that's all as far as this presentation is concerned. I hope this helps. Thank you so much.